If you want to become a data analyst, you need to know a ton of stuff. Or do you? You actually only need a few key skills to become a data analyst, and in this video, I'm not just gonna tell you to learn SQL or Tableau or whatever. We're going to explore real job listings and see the skills employers actually look for together. I'm gonna use Indeed, LinkedIn, and perhaps even more places. No theoretical stuff in this video, just pure reality. Now, this video is going to be a little bit different. It's not entirely planned like my other videos, and that's because it's simply impossible. We'll investigate this together, and I've had many requests to make a video like this, so let's just get started. Okay, so I'm not that used to doing these kind of spontaneous videos, but let's give it a try. So now we're on LinkedIn. LinkedIn is probably going to be one of your top choices when you're looking for jobs. I mean, there are a lot of them on LinkedIn, definitely more than most of the other websites out there. Now, that doesn't mean that LinkedIn is the best website. I do think that there are other advantages to some of the other websites that we'll cover, but I definitely think that you need to be using LinkedIn if you aren't doing so already. I mean, most people are. Now, all I did was I put in a data analyst in United States. You can put in whatever location you want, of course, but we're just going to go through kind of the skills together and the things that I see. I'm kind of find out if there's any patterns that we see and so on. So the first one here is going to be entry level, or at least according to them. The salary ranges around 65 to 70,000 for the New York City region, of course, based on skills, experience, and so on. So it seems like they're looking for somebody that's familiar in database applications and BI tools like Cognos, Tableau, Google Analytics, and Adobe Campaign. If you've done the Google Data Analytics certificate, you're already familiar with Tableau. If you've done the IBM one, you're familiar with the Cognos. And Google Analytics is pretty simple to learn. That's a good start. You can see that the next one is to know Python. We're going to focus on the ones that I think are going to be the most relevant, because, you know, there's going to be other tools that are not as relevant for most people. But as you can see here, Python is going to be the main one. Expertise in writing database queries in, for example, SQL. That's a very good example. Some statistical modeling, proficiency in Excel, PowerPoint, and Word. And if you don't have that, then it's time to get started. Strong analytical skills with an ability to translate raw data into clear and into a clear and concise story. So basically going from the first step to taking some data and being able to present a story and extract something from the data. This one is also focusing a little bit more on the verbal communication here, excellent written and oral communication skills, because it seems like you'll be working with upper management as well and communicating up on all levels. Could be that it's a smaller company, but it also depends on how senior you are. If you're working in a really like a major company, it's very unlikely that you'll be working directly with the like top management, of course, but it definitely depends on the company that you're working in. And data is also really important, and it seems like more and more of the kind of managers are starting to understand this, so they're kind of trying to bring the data people closer to them, and that makes a lot of sense. It is really important. The next thing is flexible and adaptive approach. Consistently support and develop new ideas. A lot of the next few ones are going to be things that you see on every single job listing. It really doesn't matter what job you're looking for, like ability to work individually and within a team. That's going to be something that's basically on whatever job you're looking for. But this is pretty interesting. An entrepreneurial mindset with the rigor and discipline to build the business and creative competencies that will allow us to stand out in the marketplace. So basically they want somebody that's willing to take some responsibility. Now, I'm not going to spend too much time on this. We're going to keep going. As you can see, we have a lot of different ones. We have all over the place. We're going to take a look at this one because I think it's interesting. Well, actually, where's the information? There we go. Okay, let's see. So the starting salary is what is this? This is very interesting. Okay, so the salary is $225,000. This is probably not a entry-level position in that case. This should be a very difficult. So we're kind of going to avoid that. I think, of course, it can be really interesting. But if they're asking for $225,000, or that's what they're willing to give, I can assure you that it's not going to be an entry-level role. So let's keep going with this one. Here we can see the responsibilities. And in this one, it's going to be a little bit more abstract, or focusing on the actual like responsibilities, not as much on the skills. You can see here, very savvy in Excel, communicate clearly with senior leadership. Again, just about like extracting the insights and being able to bring them up the chain or the ladder. Ability to balance competing priorities and manage chain. A lot of these things just basically apply to any job, and it's very hard to kind of extract things from this. Here we have working knowledge of SAP, Tableau experience again, ability to code in SQL, R, Python, etc. It doesn't mean that you have to be an expert in all of these, but it kind of shows that the skills we're talking about, they do appear in job listings all the time. And that's also why I wanted to make this video, because I talk a lot about the different skills and what you have to learn, but all the data that I'm using to bring these things forward is going to be the job market. So what really matters is what we find when we're looking for jobs. Now, in this case, they do require a bachelor's degree. It doesn't mean mean that it's like a 100% requirement. There are ways to see job listings that specifically allow people without a degree to apply or encourage it. Next one here, you can see it's in something in the private sector. This one is definitely not an entry-level one. I mean, they're talking about bachelor's degree in mathematics, statistics, CS, and 3 years of experience. But let's just check this one out because it can still be pretty interesting. Now, we don't have time to go through all of this. It's going to be a lot. So let's focus on the qualifications. Data analytics certification is a plus. And this is very interesting because I know a lot of you guys are interested, like, is it going to be valuable to get a certification? Should I get a certificate? What actually matters? Do I need a degree? But here you can see that this company actually highlights that data analytics certification is a plus. So keep that in mind when you're looking for jobs. I'm not saying that every single employer is going to care about this, but it definitely highlights that there is a opportunity to improve your resume or basically improve your qualifications by taking a certification, if it's the right one, of course. Like if you're taking some random thing, it might not help you, but there are companies that do value certifications. So keep that in mind. The next one is proficient with Excel and other Microsoft Office applications. That's pretty basic. It's going to be like Excel. Strong analytical and problem solving skills again and again, and also the ability to work with large data sets. This is very interesting. Like we may question this, how big is the data set? Because it's kind of like just saying a large data set, it can be something that's, you know, in SQL. I mean, that's larger than what we mostly deal with in Excel. So it doesn't necessarily have to be a big data, like specifically working with big data, as we like to call it. You will also need experience with different data visualization and dashboard development tools. I suppose that's what they mean. For example, Power BI, Google Analytics. And here we get to the really interesting stuff, understanding of SQL and NoSQL, the database design and construction. You will also need knowledge or experience with data science languages such as MQL, R, or Python is a plus. What I think is really interesting, perhaps if we think a little bit analytically about this, is that a lot of tools that we know, they do appear over and over. Now, there are going to be a lot of other tools and skills that come up because it depends on the company. They might be using some specific tool. They might do something in their way. In general, the basic things, they do appear in a lot of job listings. You don't need to know every single specific skill that the company is looking for. If you have the foundations, it's going to help you a lot. Of course, it's going to be an advantage if you know every single thing on their list, but most people that apply are not going to do that. So now I want to show you some other websites as well. And here we're going to take a look and see if the patterns apply even on Indeed. Now, I really like Indeed. It's actually one of my favorite platforms for looking for jobs. I guess it's just kind of a personal preference. I'm not really sure why I like it. So the thing that we're going to do is we're going to click on experience level and we're going to put no experience, or I mean, entry level is probably better. As you can see, like nobody puts this one. So let's put entry level, 3000 jobs. And of course, there can be a lot more jobs that are not accurately categorized. So keep that in mind. Like just when you click this, don't get discouraged. There can be jobs that are not with this specific tag. So we're going to take a look. Now I'm going to show you something different here because this one is a data insights analyst. And there can of course be some things that are different, but I also think it's important that you understand that you can look for related roles as well. This could very well just be a data analyst that they've kind of decided to rename. There can also be differences, of course, but let's take a look at the description here. The qualifications here seems to be kind of like a specific data analyst for their case, their thing that they're looking to do. Qualifications, growth mindset on the first one. I guess they put the hard skills last. Excellent analytical mentality again and again. Self-starter, able to work independently. And it kind of connects with the entrepreneurial mindset that we saw before. It's being able to take responsibility for a project and just keep going. Excellent communication skills again and again. We find these like growth mindset, being able to work independently, being able to communicate, and being able to function well in a team, of course. But that's kind of the general thing that they always put. So it's really interesting. SQL and Power BI proficiency would be a plus. They don't really talk about any other tool. I mean, they don't even mention Excel, but I guess that's kind of expected. There's nothing about Python here. It's only SQL and Power BI proficiency, which kind of gives me the indication that, you know, these are the tools that they work with. So again, knowing Python is going to be really helpful, but it also depends on the company. And the main thing is that we learn the skills that the companies use. I hope that this quick bonus video gave you some additional insights about the job market, or perhaps it was just a good reminder for you to check out some job listings yourself. But I think this video here on the screen will be even more helpful. So have an amazing week, guys.